afternoon. Unfortunately, Farid Assad is not able to defend the case about how drivers and road users behave on the road, but I do my best to pass the message. First of all, in fact, formal and informal rules are useful when you start looking at what are the premise or the principle of the safe system approach in road safety. Well, we know that this is what we think, the people think, that human makes mistakes, but in fact we will see that human error is not an absolute, it is relative to a reference, and also that being said this morning that the organization also play a great role in the occurrence of accident. First, the second principle is about, to get a safe system, we need, a safer road, safer vehicle, safer infrastructure, safer emergency service. But in fact, we show that, system safety, from our point of view, is a question of emergence from interaction. Then, yes, there are two systems of rules on the road. In fact, there are what we call the prescriptive task or the formal task, and what is called the redefined or informal task. So here, it is composed of formal rules or formal, which is useful to achieve the task. It's mainly prescriptions given by the highway codes. And is conceived by the designer or the manager of the system. And the redefined or informal task is what the driver, in fact, really do on the roads. And because it is all these rules in our defined on the highway code are not sufficient to achieve the driving task. Farid Assad told us that, in fact, the driving task is very complex and unstructured. And so, when you want to really interact with the other driver, you need more information. And this information comes either from the road, as it has been said, the road must be readable, or also we can learn from the interaction with the other driver. And that which constitutes, in fact, what we call the informal rules. And of course, we are able to discover, what are these informal rules by doing some research about driver behavior in ergonomics. And this also has an important role. You see the prescribed task and the redefined task when you want to make some model of error analysis. As you see, this is. And then it is a task carried out by the driver. And for the expert, of course, this is the error. But for the driver, it is not this one that is the error, but this one compares the redefined task to the task carried out. And for example, if the driver does not know exactly what is the prescribed task, he can do, he can make some violations. And break the rules for many reasons, and sometimes also, of course, he's not aware of the task, or the task is too much difficult to achieve, and then he can make some mistakes or slips. So there are, in fact, different meanings of the error and concept of error. What is important also in psychology or social psychology is the role of representation. In fact, what is important is to understand this. It's not the situation itself which determines the behavior, but its representation. So of course, we get information from the road, you have your driver knowledge, your experience, then you have a certain representation of the situation, and then you make the regulating action. And this is also another type of representation made by Norman. You see the communication between the model, design model, and the user's model is through the system, but in fact, not only the physical system, but the system image, the system representation. So it's very important to study the representation of the situation by the driver. And then we are helped in this field by the social psychology, which in fact, you know, we consider not only the relationship between the ego and the object, but also the other, alter. And when you want to have exactly what is the representation of the driving situation, you have to study the representation of the drivers, of the other drivers, the driving task, and the traffic conditions. And I now I'm going to give you some examples. For example, about speed, because we talked this morning about speed and speed limit representation. And when we want to discover what are the social representation of speed, we ask people to associate to the word speed some other words, and then to classify them from 1 to 5. And you see, and then we can define what we call the core of the representation. And in fact, here you see the word is danger and accident. This is the periphery, we call it the periphery. Là, you see pleasure, you see vigilance, limitation, and so on. And then we can make also a clustering about the driver. And you see we end with four classes. We call it the prudent, prudential people, which in fact associate speed to hazard or danger. Then we have the defiant, like Dinesh. No, we associate speed with danger and pleasure. But you know, it's a 14% of the population. And then the hedonist, they associate speed with pleasure, rapidity, gaining time. And then the pragmatist, which in fact make a balance between, okay, you can gain time, rapidity, but also you have to be careful about enforcement and vigilance and the control of speed. So you see, this is very important because from this, we were able to predict the acceptance, for example, of a system like ISA, the Intelligent Speed Adaptation, or even also the behavior of drivers on the road concerning speed. Also, what is interesting, we talk about what is science, what is common sense or common knowledge. And in fact, Moscovici, which is the researcher which has worked a lot about social representation in France, he said that science is what makes something familiar unfamiliar, and common knowledge, it's what makes something unfamiliar from science familiar for us. And when you look at, for example, the car following, car following is not so easy to maintain the distance between two cars. And so, in fact, we can say it is regulated by this type of equation with algorithm. And these algorithms are now included in an autonomous car. But in fact, there is a knowledge based on that. And we end with some kind of regulation which we can discover when we study how people behave on the road. And so I would like to end with what kind of system we are driving in. So in fact, as you see, when we analyze the driver behavior, we widen the scope of interaction, the agent with the environment, talk about the readability of the road, and also the social, we could call it social situationism, because, you know, in fact, the driving also is a social phenomena. When we really want to make a step more, we can say there are two types, in fact, of systems. We can say this is, on one side, we have a tractable and loose system, which is a reified universe, heteronomous, the norm The norm comes from outside, from the state, from the government. And the safety, it says the rule safety or safety by constraint. And you have an image here of what it could be, a lot of signal, etc. And then on the other side, we have something more consensual based on autonomy, which is untractable as the complexity arises here. It's very complex, of course, to model this and tight system, because you know each action has a consequence, and what is called is manager safety. So you see, this is a travel through quick travel through formal and informal rules dealing with psychology, social psychology, and the conclusion is that of course we know that the incompleteness of formal rules and the necessity to study informal rules with a pluridisciplinary approach. Then also driving is social, and the origin of the rules is found into the social representation of the driving situation, as I show you about speed. And the existence of these two formal and informal rule system must be recognized and taken advantage in order to reconcile two modes of safety, regulated and managed. Thank you.
Thank you.